Hello, today we'll be reviewing the science fiction action movie, Code 8. The film opens, and we see a brief history of people with superhuman abilities, who are called powers. In the beginning, the public accepted the powers and appreciated them. Later, machines began to replace them and the public began to dislike the powers. Then a dangerous drug known as psych began to spread, which came from the spinal fluid of the powers. Tensions grew, and there was a call to ban all powers, and comprehensive security was installed to detect them. A robotic militarized police force was introduced called Guardians, and they were paired with advanced drones to hunt down the powers. We then see the protagonist of the film, Connor Reed, who is 26 and has the powers of a Class 5 electrokinetic. He looks after his mother Mary, who is a cryokinetic and with brain cancer that causes her to act strangely. Connor lives as a hidden power and struggles to afford his mother's medical bills. He works a labor job with other hidden unregistered powers and installs wiring using his electrokinetic abilities. While on the job, the police arrive, who say they have heard reports of powers being used. Connor and the workers are forced to line up and they are scanned to see their abilities. One man refuses to look up and be scanned, and when he finally does, it is revealed he has a warrant. He uses his flame powers to escape from the police and sprints away down the street. As he runs, two guardians are dropped from an overhead ship and they quickly gun him down with no mercy. Meanwhile, a major psych drug bust is underway and more guardians are dropped at the building. They raid the apartment building and arrest a man and seize millions of dollars worth of the spinal fluid drug. This is part of their major operation to locate and destroy all traces of psych from the city. At the store where Connor's mom works, Mary spills some groceries from her episodes and is scolded by the manager. Connor enters the store and begins to argue with the man, and his eyes flash as gets angry. The manager realizes he is a power and kicks both him and his mother out. As they drive, Connor insists that his mother starts chemo, but she tells him they simply do not have enough money. Mary tells Connor she is acting like his father who passed away, and he tells her he will find a way to make more money. The next day, Connor and the other workers are approached by a drug runner named Garrett, who works for crime lord Marcus Scuffield. He is looking for someone with electric powers and needs at least a class 2. Despite warnings from others, Connor volunteers but says he needs $200 upfront. He rides with the gang to a chemical plant and uses his powers to break through a 10,000 voltage gate. The group steals some barrels, but they are confronted by a security guard. He goes to radio them in, but the group leader, Garrett, uses his telekinesis powers to steal the radio. They lock him in a dumpster and head out, but the chemical break is reported to some guardian ships overhead. Connor wants to get dropped off, but they tell him the job is not done. They get tracked by a ship, but they manage to rip off the outer red layer of the van, so they no longer match the description. The group finally arrives at a nightclub and meets drug lord Marcus Scuffield, who is able to read minds. Connor is shown around by Marcus' apparent girlfriend Nia, and we learn that Marcus is bankrupt and in need of money. He is being threatened by his superiors, called the Trust, to give them their cut, and he only has a week to deliver. But Marcus states he has a big lead, and he tells Garrett to train Connor to become stronger. Garrett drives Connor home and tells him if he wants to make more money, he should join them again tomorrow morning for another job. He tells him he's got talent and he shouldn't waste it. In the house, his mom asks him where he was, and he lies saying he had a construction job. Back at the chemical plant, police investigate the scene. Only barrels of hydro were stolen, so they know Marcus is hurting for money and watering down his drugs. They wonder how many electrics in town are strong enough to blow the fence, and they plan to pull some names to investigate. The next morning, Connor is waiting outside for another job, and Garrett and his crew pull up. He joins them again, and Garrett tells him in 3 days they are going to rob a bank, and until then, Connor will be training with him. As they drive, Connor talks about his father and reveals he was an electric too, but was shot when he was young. Because of this, Connor's mom raised him without powers to try and keep him safe, so that is why he does not know his full strength. For the next few days, Connor trains with Garrett and helps him with his drug operation. He grows stronger each day and begins to understand how to be himself and use his powers. Connor accompanies Garrett to a drug deal and gets in a confrontation with another electric who shorted their money. The electric attacks, but Connor retaliates and proves he is the strongest. Garrett begins to tell him to be who he is, and if he sees something he wants, Connor takes this to heart and confronts the store manager, who mistreated his mother, and threatens him to treat her better. More time goes by, and Connor has almost mastered his powers and surge ability, and now has a hidden pile of money in his dresser. Meanwhile, the two policemen, Park and Davis, begin to conduct surveillance on Connor as he matches the description from the chemical plant. They know he is piled with medical bills and plan to keep an eye on him. It It is the night of the robbery, and the gang enters the bank with masks on. The guards raise their weapons, but one is electrocuted, and the other is pushed against the wall by Garrett's telekinesis. They put everyone on the ground, and Connor shorts the bank security system, which triggers the alarm. They force a worker to enter a code, and the police are notified of the robbery and send a unit, which is 4 minutes away. Connor and the group enter the vault, but find there is only $50,000 instead of the expected $500,000. They grab the cash and escape out the back door, but are confronted by a police ship. They tell them to get on the ground or they will shoot, but Connor manages to create a massive electrical surge that hits the ship and takes it out. All other police are notified that there is a high-level electric loose, and they are all dispatched towards the bank. As the group drives away, they all swear in anger that the vault was not full. They get back to the nightclub, and Marcus asks them where the rest of the money is, and they break the news. Suddenly, a shapeshifter from Marcus' superiors pulls out a gun and fires at him. Rhino, the bodyguard, jumps in front of the bullets and uses his power of bulletproof skin to deflect them. The shapeshifter turns to shoot Mia, but Connor jumps in and electrocutes her. She charges toward him, but she is shot and killed by Rhino. They remove her body, and Connor finds Mia in the kitchen. She grabs his arm where he was cut and heals it using her powers. We find out she is a healer, and the only reason she is with Marcus is to help heal his addiction and pay off a debt she owes. Back at home, Connor's mother finds his stash and asks where he got all the money. She knows what he is doing, and she is upset that he is using his powers like his father was. Connor says it is his only option to save her, and suddenly Mary begins to convulse and pass out. She is taken to the hospital, and the doctor tells Connor a tumor is pressing against her brain. For her to have a chance, they need to operate on her right away, which will be a costly procedure. Outside of the hospital, Connor is confronted by the two policemen, Davis and Park. They interrogate him and encourage him to cooperate, because they say Marcus will be taken down soon anyway. They know about his sick mother, and Park offers to help him if he can give them something on Marcus. Davis plays a bad cop and says he would like nothing more than to bury Connor like his father was. Connor's eyes begin to glow in rage, and he refuses to help them, saying, "You've got the wrong guy." Finally, Park decides to let him go because they have no evidence, but Davis is mad and wants to frame him with drugs. They argue, but ultimately decide to cut him loose. Connor then heads to meet Marcus and proposes they rob the psych that was removed off the streets. There is $10 million worth of the drug that will be incinerated in 3 days, and he wants to steal it back. Connor says if they do this job, Marcus can keep all the psych, but he gets to have Mia so she can be taken to heal his dying mother. Marcus thinks it over, but finally agrees to the deal. Garrett then states that he wants to split this job 50-50, and Marcus seems to reluctantly agree. The group begins to plan for the heist, and they will block a truck full of guardians in a no-fly zone. Drones will not be able to come help, and Connor will have one shot to use his surge and destroy them all. If he is successful, this will give the gang the time they need to steal the psych. Before the robbery, Connor tells Mia that once she heals his mother she can be free, but she says everyone only cares about her because she can heal, and Connor is no different. The day of the robbery arrives, and Freddy blocks the road using his super strength. The truck enters the no-fly zone and comes across Freddy's blockade, so they have to take a different route. As they drive, they are stopped by a garbage truck driven by Garrett. Connor stands in the alley to the side, and his hands begin to flash with electricity. They wonder what he is waiting for, and his veins begin to glow, and his hair stands straight up. He finally unleashes a surge and destroys the truck engine and the guardians. Two guardians survived, but Garrett holds them down, and Connor runs over and finishes them off. The other group members spring into action and break into the truck. They burn a hole into the side and slip in a grenade, forcing the police out. The drones outside the no-fly zone decide to break the rules and enter the area. Maddie hands off the psych to Rhino, the bodyguard, and the policemen beg to be spared now that they have what they want. But suddenly the gang executes the officers, and Rhino turns on Maddie and shoots her in the neck. They then fire at Garrett, Connor, and Freddy, and Rhino flees with all of the drugs. Connor and Garrett realize Marcus has betrayed them after Garrett demanded they split the deal half and half. The three of them escape through an alleyway as Marcus' men are shot down by two guardians. They manage to steal a car and drive away as police pass them. Back at the nightclub, Mia asks where the others are, but Marcus just smirks and gives her more psych. He tells her that her dad still owes her a lot of money, and her debt has not been repaid yet. Connor and Garrett manage to escape the city, but Freddy has been shot and dies in the backseat of the car. Connor tells Garrett this is his fault, and the plan was solid until he decided to get greedy, and the two part ways. Back at the police station, Park and Davis are yelled at for not arresting Connor when they had him in their possession. The captain tells them to find everyone who did this, or they will be held responsible. Connor manages to get to the hospital, and he tells his mother he is sorry. She tells him he has to stop, and that he needs to let her go. Park then visits his daughter, who is actually a telekinesis power. He takes her out, and she questions if she is going to be given away, because she cannot control her powers. Outside, Park is then approached by a stranger who gives him a note. It tells Park where to meet Connor, and the two sit together at a restaurant. Connor says he will turn himself in after he helps his mother, and offers Park the location of Marcus' hideout. The police send surveillance drones and discover a large amount of drug runners going in and out. They launch a raid and load up in trucks and ships. Four guardians are dropped outside the exits, and the ground units breach and begin shooting. During the firefight, Marcus, Rhino, and Mia escape through the secret tunnel, but they are stopped by Garrett and Connor, who are seeking revenge. Garrett shoots Marcus, and he falls, then fires at Rhino, who blocks the bullets using his power. He charges at Garrett, and he holds him back using telekinesis, and Connor electrocutes him. The three begin to fight, and Marcus pulls out a gun and threatens Nia to fix him or die. Rhino is killed, and Nia approaches Marcus, but grabs his gun. The group stands over him, and Garrett delivers the final blow in revenge for Freddy and Maddie. Connor then tells Nia she needs to heal his mom, and she's free to go. However, she reveals that when she heals people, the injury is transferred to her. By healing Mary, she would most likely die from the disease. Garrett hands Connor a gun and tells him to take what he is here for, and he leaves with all the psych. Connor takes Nia to the hospital at gunpoint and tells her to save her. She begins to heal her, but the effects are transferred to her, and she cries in pain from what is happening. Connor finally tells her to stop after seeing how painful it is for her, and he remembers what his mother told him about letting her go. With tears in his eyes, he says goodbye to his mother, and she dies. Connor then drives to the police station to turn himself in. He gives Nia his truck to escape the city and tells her he is sorry for what he did to her. She asks what he will do now, and he tells her he is going into the station to make things right. 5 weeks later, the city is voting on whether to permanently ban all powers after the four policemen died in the robbery. Park and Davis are granted with awards for their work, but Park reluctantly accepts and thinks about his daughter. Garrett meets with the trust and pays them double what Marcus owed as he takes over as the leader of the drug trade in the city. Nia finally gets to visit her father in prison, whose debt she was paying off with Marcus. Before serving his sentence, Connor is allowed to visit his mother's grave, and he tells her he won't be able to visit for a while. He hopes to make things right and tells his mother to watch over him, and the movie comes to a close.